Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. This is lecture number 11 in Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. We are going to solve problems in the isentropic flow, part 3. In the earlier four lectures, we discussed the theory part and solved problems in the isentropic flow. And in this lecture also, we continue with the problem solving from the anonymous question paper in the isentropic flow. The learning outcome to the students, the student will be able to solve problems in the isentropic flow in the nozzle and diffuser. Example number 11 from May 2009 and May 2010 question paper. A conical diffuser has an entry and exit diameter of 150 millimeter and 300 millimeter respectively. The pressure, temperature and air velocity at the entry are 69 kilopascal, 67 degree Celsius and 180 meters per second respectively. Determine exit pressure, exit velocity and the force exerted on the diffuser wall. Assuming isentropic flow, you take gamma equal to 1.4 and Cp equal to 1 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. We write down the given data. Diameter D1 equal to 0.15 meter, D2 exit diameter is 0.3 meter, pressure at inlet 69 kilopascal, temperature 67 degree Celsius which is 340 Kelvin, C1 velocity 180 meters per second, gamma equal to 1.4 and Cp equal to 1 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Area of the diffuser at inlet and the exit, A1 equal to pi by 4 D1 square which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.15 square equal to 0.01766 meter square and A2 area at the exit of the diffuser pi by 4 D2 square into which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.3 square equal to 0.071 meter square. So, the gas constant of the air R equal to Cp into gamma minus 1 by gamma which is 1000 into 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 286 joules per kilogram Kelvin. The Mach number at the inlet of the diffuser M1 equal to C1 divided by square root of gamma RT1 which is 180 divided by square root of 1.4 into 286 into 340 equal to 0.49. So, from isentropic table 3.2 page number 29. At M1 equal to 0.49 and gamma equal to 1.4, we take T1 by TO1 equal to 0.954, P1 by PO1 equal to 0.848, F1 by F star equal to 1.216, A1 by A star equal to 1.36. Now, the stagnation properties, TO1 equal to T1 divided by 0.954 equal to 340 divided by 0.954 equal to 356.4 Kelvin. PO1 equal to P1 divided by 0.848 equal to 69 divided by 0.848 equal to 81.37 bar. A star area at the throat section A1 by 1.36 equal to 0.0176 divided by 1.36 equal to 0.013 meter square. Now area at the exit, area ratio at the exit A2 by A star equal to 0.071 divided by 0.013 equal to 5.46. Now, from the isentropic table 3.2, page number 28, at A2 by A star equal to 5.46 and gamma equal to 1.4, we take M2 equal to 0.107, T2 by TOT equal to 0.9977, P2 by POT equal to 0.9923, F1 by F star equal to 4.34. Temperature, pressure and velocity at the exit, T2 equal to 0.9977 into TOT equal to 0.9977, into 356.4 equal to 355.58 Kelvin, P2 equal to 0.9923 into PO2 equal to 0.9923 into 81.37 equal to 80.34 kilopascal and C2 equal to M2 into square root of gamma RT2 which is 0.107 into square root of 1.4 into 286 into 355.58 equal to 40.4 meters per second. And the force exerted on the wall of the diffuser, tau equal to F2 minus F1 which is F1 into F2 by F1 minus 1. F1 the impulse function at the inlet of the diffuser, at inlet condition P1 A1 into 1 plus gamma M1 square. So, here we divide by F star both numerator and denominator, F2 by F star divided by F1 by F star minus 1. So, substituting numerical values, tau equal to P1 equal to 69,000 Pascal into 0.01766 into 1 plus 1.4 into 0.49 square into 4.34. F2 by F star equal to 4.34. F1 by F star equal to 1.216 minus 1. So, calculating the force exerted, tau equal to 4182.8 Newton. The answer to the problem, exit pressure is 80.74 bar, exit velocity is 40.4 meters per second. The force exerted on the diffuser wall equal to 4182.8 Newton. Example number 12 from November 2009 question paper. In an isentropic flow, diffuser inlet area is 0.15 meter square. At the inlet, velocity is 240 meters per second. Static temperature is 300 Kelvin. Static pressure is 0.7 bar. Air leaves a diffuser with a velocity of 120 meters per second. Calculate at the exit, the mass flow rate, stagnation pressure, stagnation temperature, area and entropy change across the diffuser. This is from November 2009 question paper. We are given A1 equal to 0.15 meter square, velocity C1 equal to 240 meters per second, P1 pressure P1 equal to 0.7 bar, temperature T1 equal to 300 Kelvin. The property at the exit, velocity at the exit is C2 equal to 120 meters per second. Mach number at the inlet condition, M1 equal to C1 divided by square root of gamma RT1, which is equal to 240 divided by 1.4 into 287 into 300 equal to 0.69. From isentropic table 3.2, page number 30, at the Mach number M1 equal to 0.69 and gamma equal to 1.4, T1 by T1 equal to 0.913 and P1 by P1 equal to 0.727. Now here, calculating the stagnation properties, TO1 equal to T1 divided by 0.913 equal to 300 divided by 0.913 equal to 328.6 Kelvin. PO1 equal to P1 divided by 0.727, which is 0.7 divided by 0.727 equal to 0.963 bar. The temperature ratio at the exit, so we calculate the temperature at the exit, T2 equal to TO2 minus C2 square by 2Cp. So, from the given information, we calculate the static temperature at the outlet of the diffuser. So, 328.6 minus 120 square divided by 2 into 1005 equal to 321.4 Kelvin. T2 by TO2 equal to 321.4 divided by 328.6 equal to 0.978. Now, from the isentropic table 3.2, page number 29, at the T2 by TO2 equal to 0.978 and gamma equal to 1.4. We take M2 equal to 0.33 and P2 by PO2 equal to 0.927. So, pressure and density at the exit. So, P2 equal to 0.927 into PO2, which is 0.927 into 0.963 equal to 0.893 bar. And rho2 equal to P2 by R into T2, 0.893 in 10 power 5 divided by 287 into 321.4 equal to 0.968 kilograms per meter cube. The mass flow rate from the inlet conditions, M equal to rho1 A1 C1, which is equal to P1 by RT1 into A1 into C1. We are given area at the inlet, A1 is 0.15 meter square. So, we calculate M equal to 0.7 into 10 power 5 divided by 287 into 300 into 0.15 into 240 equal to 29.27 kilograms per second. The area at the exit, A2 equal to M divided by A2 C2, rho2 C2, so 29.27 divided by 0.968 into 120 equal to 0.252 meter square. The answer to the problem, mass flow rate is 29.27 kilograms per second, stagnation pressure is 0.963 bar, stagnation temperature is 328.6 Kelvin, area at the exit is 0.252 meter square, entropy change across diffuser is 0 for isentropic flow. Example number 13, a conical diffuser has an inlet diameter of 40 cm and an exit diameter of 80 cm. The air enters the diffuser with a static pressure of 200 kPa, static temperature of 37 degrees Celsius and a velocity of 265 meters per second. Calculate the mass flow rate, properties at the exit. What will be the change in the force exerted on the diffuser wall? So, this question is from November 2009 and November 2013. Diameter D1 equal to 0.4 meter, diameter D2 equal to 0.8 meter, pressure P1 equal to 200 kPa, T1 equal to 37 degrees Celsius, which is 310 Kelvin, and C1 equal to 265 meters per second. So, we have to calculate the area of the diffuser at the inlet and the outlet. So A2 equal to A1 equal to pi by 4 D1 square, which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.4 square equal to 0.1256 meter square. And A2 equal to pi by 4 D2 square, which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.8 square equal to 0.5024 meter square. The Mach number at the inlet condition, M1 equal to C1 divided by square root of gamma RT1, which is 265 divided by square root of 1.4 into 287 into 310 equal to 0.75. From isentropic table 3.2 page number 30, at M1 equal to 0.75 and gamma equal to 1.4, we take the properties T1 by TO1 equal to 0.899, P1 by P1 equal to 0.688, F1 by F star equal to 1.031, A1 by A star equal to 1.062. We calculate the properties, stagnation properties, TO1 equal to T1 divided by 0.899 equal to 310 divided by 0.899 equal to 344.84 Kelvin. PO1 equal to P1 by 0.688 equal to 200 divided by 0.688 equal to 290.77 kilopascal. And A star equal to A1 divided by 1.062 equal to 0.1256 divided by 1.062 equal to 0.118 meter square. The area ratio at the exit A2 by A star equal to 0.5024 divided by 0.118 equal to 4.26. Now from the isentropic table 3.2 page number 28, A2 by A star equal to 4.26 and gamma equal to 1.4. We take M2 equal to 0.1375, T2 by TO2 equal to 0.9961, P2 by PO2 equal to 0.9865, F2 by F star equal to 3.4. Now the pressure, temperature and velocity at the exit of the diffuser, T2 equal to 0.9961 into TO2, which is 0.9961 into 344.84 equal to 343.45 Kelvin. P2 equal to 0.9865 into PO2 equal to 0.9865 into 290.77 equal to 286.8 kilopascal. And C2 equal to M2 into square root of gamma RT2. So M2 equal to 0.1375 into square root of 1.4 into 287 in 343.45 equal to 51.1 meters per second. Density of the air at the exit of the diffuser, rho 2 equal to P2 by R into T2, 286.8 into 10 power 3 divided by 287 into 343.45 equal to 2.91 kilograms per meter cube. Mass flow rate, M equal to rho 2 A2 C2 at the outlet conditions, 2.91 into 0.5024 into 51.1 equal to 74.7 kilograms per second. And the force exerted on the wall of the diffuser, tau equal to F2 minus F1 equal to F1 into F2 by F1 minus 1. F1, the impulse function at the inlet of the diffuser, which is P1 into A1 into 1 plus gamma into M1 square into, we divide by F star both numerator denominator, F2 by F star divided by F1 by F star minus 1. So, substituting numerical values, 200 into 10 power 3 into 0.1256 into 1 plus 1.4 into 0.75 square into 3.4 divided by 1.031 minus 1. Calculating the shear, the force exerted on the wall of the diffuser, tau equal to 103,174.4 Newton. So, the answer to the problem, mass flow rate equal to 74.7 kilograms per second. Properties at the exit, P2 equal to 286.8 kilopascal, T2 equal to 343.45 Kelvin. The force exerted on the diffuser wall, 103,174.4 Newton. Example number 14 from May 2010 question paper. A supersonic diffuser delivers air from a Mach number of 3 and 1.5 in the isentropic flow. The static condition of the air at the inlet are 70 kilopascal and minus 7 degree Celsius. The mass flow rate of the air is 125 kilograms per second. Determine the stagnation condition, area at the throat and the exit, stagnation condition of the air at the, static condition of the air at the exit. So we are given Mach number 1 equal to 3, Mach number 2 at the section 2 is 1.5. It is completely supersonic diffuser. P1 equal to 70 kilopascal, T1 equal to 266 Kelvin, minus 7 degree Celsius equal to 266 Kelvin, and the mass flow rate is 125 kilograms per second. From isentropic table 3.2, page number 37, at M1 equal to 3 and gamma equal to 1.4, we take T1 by T1 equal to 0.357, P1 by P1 equal to 0.0272, A1 by A star equal to 4.235. So, the stagnation property is T1 equal to T1 divided by 0.357 equal to 266 divided by 0.357 equal to 745.1 Kelvin, and the P1 equal to P1 divided by 0.0272 equal to 70 divided by 0.0270 equal to 2573.5 kilopascal. From isentropic table 3.2 page number 32 at the Mach number M2 equal to 1.5 and gamma equal to 1.4. We take the properties T2 by TO2 equal to 0.689, P2 by PO2 equal to 0.272, A2 by A star equal to 1.176. Now the temperature, pressure and velocity at the exit. So T2 equal to 0.689 into TO2 equal to 0.689 into 745.1 equal to 513.3 Kelvin. P2 equal to 0.272 into PO2, which is 0.272 into 2573.5 equal to 700 kilopascal. Velocity at the exit. C2 equal to M2 into square root of gamma RT2, which is 1.5 into square root of 1.4 into 287 into 513.3 equal to 681.2 meters per second. Density at the exit of the diffuser, rho2 equal to P2 by R into T2, which is 700 into 10 power 3 divided by 287 into 513.3 equal to 4.75 kilograms per meter cube. The area at the exit of the diffuser, A2 equal to M mass flow rate divided by rho2 C2, which is 125 divided by 4.75 into 681.2, which is 0.0386 meter square. Area at the throat section, A star equal to A2 by 1.176, which is 0.0386 divided by 1.176 equal to 0.0328 meter square. So, the answer to the problem, stagnation condition, PO equal to 2573.5 kilopascal, TO equal to 745.1 Kelvin, areas at the throat and the exit section, A star equal to 0.0328 meter square, A2 equal to 0.0386 meter square, static condition of the air at the exit, P2 equal to 700 kilopascal and T2 equal to 513.3 Kelvin. Example number 15 from November 2012 question paper, the Mach number and the pressure at the entry of a subsonic diffuser is 0.9 and 4.165 bar. Determine the area ratio required and the pressure rise if the Mach number at the exit of the diffuser is 0.2. Assume isentropic diffusion of air. So, we are given Mach number M1 equal to 0.9, M2 equal to 0.2 and pressure P1 equal to 4.165 bar. From isentropic table 3.2 page number 30 at M1 equal to 0.9 and gamma equal to 1.4, P1 by P1 equal to 0.591, A1 by A star equal to 1.009. Again from isentropic table 3.2 page number 28 at M2 equal to 0.2 and gamma equal to 1.4, P2 by P2 equal to 0.973, A2 by A star equal to 2.964. Area ratio A2 by A1 equal to A2 by A star divided by A1 by A star, substituting 2.964 divided by 1.009 equal to 2.94. The pressure rise across the diffuser delta P equal to P2 minus P1, we can write as P1 into P2 by P1 minus 1, which is P1 into P2 by P2 divided by P1 by P1 minus 1. So, substituting delta P equal to 4.165 into 0.973 divided by 0.591 minus 1 equal to 2.692 bar. So, the area answer to the problem, area ratio equal to 2.94, pressure rise equal to 2.692 bar. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. You may find the gas dynamics and jet propulsion in the list. You can refer to the book for additional problem in the isentropic flow. I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again with another video lecture in the gas dynamics and jet propulsion. Until then, bye bye.